I wanted to add a brief three-piece personal preference to tiling success. Number one, I use a leader or I roll it down onto the take-up. This is a 500 or a 300. And then once it's on the take-up, then I send the job. I do not tape it to the core while it's running, and the reason I don't do that is because tiling is such a critical thing for consistency that I don't want to open the door for any possibility that the first tile or the initial tile is different in some way between the other tiles. Also, I tend to, whether it's the 300 or the 500, I determine the tension that's necessary. On the 365, for example, I adjust the cantilevers, or the counterweights. On a 500 series, I determine if I need regular or normal or extra tension. And then I go in and I choose, for the 500, I choose image quality after it's on the take-up reel. I go to image quality, and then from image quality, I choose step alignment, and I initiate the OMAS again after it's on the take-up reel. I do the same thing on the 365, but that's done automatically. When it's on the take-up reel, you hit take-up reel and you hit enable, and then it recalibrates based on what tension is applied from the take-up reel. I want to have the OMAS step alignment calibrated after I have the material secured onto the take-up reel. That's one. Number two, use the optimize for tiling modes. That's what they're there for. We built those so that when you optimize for tiling, what you're doing in a sense is you're cloning an existing media, but then you're telling the printheads that we're going to use even a more restrictive and a more controlled temperature setting, and then you recalibrate. So if I had an IJ180 and I was doing a lot of vehicle wraps, a lot of tiling, I would say adhesive vinyl, optimize for tiling. It would then ask me, what do you want to base it on? I would choose it on the IJ180 I'm already using. It would ask me to recalibrate. I would do that, and then it would create a separate mode that is optimized for tiling for IJ180. I would do that for wall covering or for adhesive vinyl or anything that I'm doing where there's going to be a lot of tiling and panel print. I want everything to print the same, and we created that as a feature to support people who are very focused on tile printing. If you do not have the latest and greatest firmware, you will not see that. Make sure you update your firmware, then you will see when you create new media, you'll see optimize for tiling. You want to use that, especially if you're doing a lot of tiling jobs. We have introduced that to more strictly control the way that the printer works to ensure that the color is very consistent at the beginning of a print all the way to an end of a print. The last thing that I do, which is my preference, is before I run a tiling job, so I have, say, my new wall covering and I loaded it on there, it's all ready to go. I go in and I hit color calibrate. I hit color calibrate before I do any large or mission critical or color critical panel job. The reason I do is I'm going to create the best color baseline or fingerprint that I possibly can just before I do it. Puts all the settings right in line, job is going. Then sometimes what happens is you print 20 panels. It's sent out. 2 weeks later you get a call. One of the installers goofed up one of the panels. You have to reprint it. 2 weeks of this is my approach. I color calibrate. Everything was dialed in to that color calibration right when I did it. I would then load the media up, print the missing panel, let's say it's panel 3, right away. Then I would go and hit color calibrate, let it print the chart, and then I would print the panel again. Now I have two panels. One is thinking I'm as close, even though I'm still very close to the way the color look did it. But if not, I'm going to hit color calibrate again, have the machine dial it in, and then create an insurance piece that one of those two is going to be very close. Now, if you prefer, you can just do the one as is, or you can hit color calibrate and then do it right after it, which in theory should match exactly. But since the third panel of a 20-panel job and getting this thing clear and getting job completed and moving on is probably more important, and in many cases you're shipping it to a remote location, I would probably do both. Honestly, I think it's just an insurance policy to send them both. One, the 2 weeks have gone by and I print as is. The next one, I did color calibrate, dialed it right back to the day that I started the job, and then run it again. What I'm doing is I'm trying to create a workflow for tiling and paneling so that I'm exacting more precision about the take-up reel. I'm enacting more precision about the control of the printheads using the optimized tiling mode. And then I'm also making sure that when I do the job, I just hit color calibrate. That color calibration puts everything in a baseline, creates a reference point that is current, very current, and then any drift that takes place will be minimal. I find those three things are very helpful for being successful with tiling and panel printing, and I thought I would pass those along to you.